Let's talk for a moment about the intersection of physics, psychology, and philosophy. Using physics principles as an explanation for human behavior and thought patterns. Momentum and our emotions. In physics, momentum is the product of an object's mass and velocity. This shows how difficult it could be to stop an object in motion. Let's imagine that our thoughts are moving on a foundation that has the weight of our emotions on an undefined scale that makes it more than one, and infinite velocity. By this logic, our habits, thoughts, and actions, when unrestrained, often gain infinite psychological momentum. When we repeatedly think, feel, or behave in a certain way, those patterns become a part of us because that's the easy choice that our body and our mind makes. We are unable to look at the surroundings because of the high momentum and unable to exercise control over our body and our mind. Much like an object continuing its motion due to the high momentum and inertia. For example, if you're psychologically inclined towards feeling anger each time a certain person shares his side of the story with you, each instance of putting that person down reinforces that behavior. Even at points where that person may be making sense or just sharing his part of the day. Your vantage point starts from a vision of superiority and not on an equal platform. This is akin to an object in motion, staying in motion unless acted upon by an external force. This is one of Newton's laws. Friction as control. In physics, friction is the force that opposes motion, causing an object to slow down or stop. In our minds, friction can be thought of as a conscious effort, self-awareness, or intentional resistance to automatic behaviors we recognize in ourselves. Can also be useful to maneuver our minds to a simpler or calmer place where we continue to see the same emotion with a sense of calm and resolve. This could be seen as a force we apply to disrupt unhealthy patterns and create new beneficial ones. For instance, to stop feeling of anger, you might introduce a mental friction by setting small, achievable goals, practicing mindfulness, or using simple tools like self-discovery. Why you feel that way about that certain person? Has it sprung from an emotional relationship you share with that individual that gives you a feeling of superiority, ego that makes you feel like you want to be in control? Whether that anger was genuinely pointed towards motivating or inspiring that other person? Recognizing whether that anger lasted too long for that end. Was it driven by your ego? You don't have to share this self-discovery process with anybody. And you are free to be with your own thoughts, without judgment. These deliberate actions slow the momentum of your habitual anger. This will make the conversation more productive. This technique can be used to recognize genuineness of all emotions in the social context. Happiness, anger, guilt, sadness, etc. And to manifest that in your actions. When we allow our thoughts and habits to operate unchecked, we become carried away by their momentum. Negative thoughts can spiral, unhealthy habits can escalate, and we may feel as though we're losing control, or we're not in control. This happens because the brain naturally seeks efficiency, favoring familiar patterns like habits, over new energy-intensive processes. Repeated behaviors strengthen neural pathways, making them automatic over time. This can be used to our advantage by structuring our neural pathways to recognize positivity. Momentum builds through reinforcement. Each time a habit is repeated, it becomes easier to repeat again. Creating friction to regain control over our minds and our actions can give us immense power. We can introduce friction by disrupting these patterns. Awareness is a tool that recognizes when you're on autopilot and identifies the behaviors or thoughts gaining momentum. We can pause and reflect, create a moment of stillness to interrupt the flow. This is akin to applying the brakes to a moving car. Regular mindfulness practices strengthen your ability to resist old patterns and choose new, intentional paths. Just as physics governs the movement of objects, the principles of momentum and friction apply to human nature as well. Without awareness and effort, we are carried by the inertia of our thoughts and habits. By consciously applying mental friction, we can change direction, slow down, or even stop behaviors that no longer serve us. ultimately creating new momentum aligned with our goals and values.